John Langler, we start in Pensacola, Florida. Police there are investigating a second deadly shooting at a U.S. naval base in less than 3 days. Three people are dead, including the shooter. Seven other people are injured. Naomi Raccoom reports.
Naval Air Station Pensacola will remain closed for the rest of the day following a mass shooting at the base.
Walking through the crime scene was like being on the set of a movie.
Authorities say the shooter is among those killed.
It was a member of the Escambia County Sheriff's Office that did negate the threat. I will share that with you.
Several people were taken to the hospital, including two sheriff's deputies who were shot while confronting the shooter. Their injuries are not life-threatening.
My heart goes out to those families of the deceased and of the wounded. They're part of the Navy family.
NAS Pensacola is one of the Navy's most historic bases. It employs more than 16,000 military and 7,400 civilian personnel.
Certainly this is a tragic day for the city of Pensacola. NAS is incredibly an important part of our community. For 200 years, this has been a part of the city of Pensacola.
A spokesperson says only essential personnel will be allowed onto the base while the investigation continues. Naomi Ruckham, CBS News, New York.
In this case, the shooting suspect was an aviation officer in the Saudi Air Force. The FBI is investigating to determine if this was a terrorism-related incident.